Welcome to today's episode. Today's episode, we're going to be talking about the new MG Electric that's been spotted tested on the road. And also we're going to be talking about, is CCS a bit of a problem technology? So the MG has been spotted testing on the roads. It's been announced by MG a while ago that they're going to start having an electric, full electric car on the roads. And a bit of Chinese flair was put on and showed on testing on UK roads. But now an actual one has been spotted. It was on a forum that I'm in, a car dealer forum for car dealers, and someone had it spotted charging at another car dealer site. So these are the spy images, well not spy images, these are the images of it actually being tested on the UK roads, being used at different charging locations, different charging speeds. I don't know too much details about it, it's still pretty much a prototype. I don't expect the interior to look anything like this, but the exterior, I do expect that this will probably be looking what the final product will look like. It'll be quite an interesting price point because I imagine being an MG, it's going to be fairly cheap and compete very well with stuff like the Renault Zoe. The thing here is, how well built is it going to be? I don't know if people know about MG's history, but MG is now owned by China. It used to be a British manufacturer, but now it is owned by the Chinese. And the Chinese own the product, and as probably a lot of people know, China is probably one of the biggest, largest producers of electric cars in the world. So in theory, it should be a very, very, very good solid car. I'd love to know your thoughts down below in the comments. Make sure you just leave a comment. Let me know what you think about what this MG will be like. Where do you think it will price? Main question is it going to go with CHAdeMO or CCS? And this also neatly brings us on to our second subject. And our second subject is CCS a failed charging solution? Tesla Bjorn, I really can't pronounce his name. I'm not even going to try and murder it any more than I already am. But the famous YouTuber who tests a lot of Tesla cars had a Model 3 when he was plugged in to charge up his car. He saw a Model 3 plugging into what's known as a hypercharger in Norway, 175 kilowatts. And obviously the Tesla should be able to pull quite a lot of that using its new CCS plug that the new Model 3 now comes with. So he decided to film the driver plugging it in for the very first time to one of these hyperchargers and see if it charged. It failed. Now, he did then try it on another CCS, a 50 kilowatt CCS charger, and it worked fine. Now, this could be a couple of options. It could be a fault with the car, could be a fault with the software on the charger. It could be something of a bit of a mix of both. But as people know in the UK, there's a company called EcoTricity that have all our motorway service stations, and their CCS network seems to be by far extremely unreliable to pretty much any CCS driver you talk to. It's got an extremely high failure rate. Now this was supposedly down to software issue, and EcoTricity went around to replace all these software problem chargers. Yet some of these problems still seem to occur, and it seems to occur not just with EcoTricity, but also with some other manufacturers all around the world. Now this just kind of give an indication that it might be a problem with CCS. You never heard this problem with CHAdeMO. CHAdeMO team seems to be one of the most reliable charging standards. AC is pretty reliable, obviously on the Zoe, but it is acceptable on the Zoe to a lot of problems with earthing currents and stuff like that. You very, very, very rarely hear of people having problems with CHAdeMO connection issues or handshakes. They tend to work fairly reliable. So this does, I did a video a long, long time ago thinking maybe CCS will kill CHAdeMO with Tesla having it. Maybe CHAdeMO's finished, but by the looks of it, CHAdeMO still stands as one of the most reliable standards we have. And in theory, I think it's got a very long fighting chance to remain what it is and carry on going, even in Europe. Is there room for both standards? We've had two types of fuels in ICE cars for all these years. So is there two rooms for standards, two CCS and CHAdeMO in different cars? Or would this just confuse matters for the general public? Let me know down in the comments below. Thank you very much for watching this week's video. Don't forget to give it a like. Don't forget to also check out my other videos here. Consider becoming a patron. And don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much, and I'll see you again next week. Goodbye.